Do you guys have any idea what's in there? We got fiber freaking networking, 25 gigabit per second. The only problem is that we're gonna need a way faster, not to mention bigger server in order for all of our editors to use it. Thankfully, didn't wanna slam these are very expensive. We've got just that. We are gonna be rolling 100 terabytes of PCI Express Gen 4 storage on a 100 gigabit per second fiber optic network connection today. And it's going to be a blast. Like.
Save time and money with Storyblocks. Storyblocks gets you studio quality stock video clips for a fraction of the price. Check it out today at the link in the video description.
We'll be sliding this baby into our rack soon enough, but before we do, I want to give you guys a quick tour of what Liqid calls the Badger Den. Now, Liqid is a specialist in composable PCI Express infrastructure and high-speed storage, and this is about as high-speed storage as it freaking gets. In here, we've got two 64-core, 128-thread AMD EPYC server processors, 1 terabyte of 3200 megahertz ECC registered memory, and a whopping 7 PCI Express Gen 4 expansion slots back here. 5 of which are actually full height, allowing us to hook up what Liqid calls the Honey Badger, and then do it 4 more times. That's right, we can have a total of up to 5 of these carrier boards that are each capable of handling up to 8 Gen 4 M.2 drives for absolutely mind-blowing speeds. Man, I feel like I'm on like a cooking show. I got my mixing bowl, I got my ingredients over here, I got my pre-made thing for at the end. We're only gonna be assembling one of these, but it's really important to show you guys how they go together, because this right here in a storage server is obviously the key ingredient, the storage. Sabrent sent over 32 of their 4 terabyte Rocket NVMe drives, and we chose these ones specifically for a couple of reasons. Number one, we could have gone with 8 terabyte drives, but those use QLC NAND, and in an application like a server, even one that's gonna be written to relatively frequently, we don't wanna use QLC that's going to wear out faster. Why we went Gen 3 versus Gen 4 is that A, the Gen 4 drives top out at just 2 terabytes per stick, which would have our capacity, and 2, I mean, we can only hook up at most 100 gigabit per second network card and then twin it for 200 gigabit per second. Even running Gen 3 on these things, we're gonna be so far beyond that that it's not even funny. So we'd rather have the extra capacity.
Man, this is crazy. Like, thinking back to when I built our first company storage server, we had 1 terabyte drives, uh-huh. And they were this big.
Were they SSDs? And
no, they were magnetic drives.
Oh yeah.
It was almost 9 years ago, Jake.
Yeah, geez. It's like one of those.
This is our big old heat spreader for this puppy.
Oh geez, just lay it down and then
I got
just
this.
Lay
I got
it
this.
Down. Oh Jesus.
Look at this! This is 128 terabytes of raw storage. 128 terabytes! It's like a storage sandwich, you know? Without networking though, these are pointless because we'd have no way to access them. That is where this comes in. This is a ConnectX 6 100 gigabit per second network card with not one, but 2 100 gigabit ports on it. That's right, a total of up to 20 gigabytes per second, and I'm rounding, which doesn't work when the numbers get so big. So it's like 24, 25 gigabytes a second or something like that. It's flipping nuts.
25, yeah.
And I gotta bury it because the half height slots are way in the back of the thing here. They're in the bottom. You gotta dig them out. You gotta excavate. One of the sick things about AMD EPYC is that because it uses PCI Express Gen 4, you can actually get the full capabilities out of a card like this. If you were using PCI Express Gen 3, your slot would not actually be fast enough to keep up with both of these ports being used fully at the same time. Freaking nuts, right? A PCI Express 16X slot. That's for like graphics cards. While we've got this opened up, it's a good opportunity to show you guys how expansion can be handled a little differently in servers. On your motherboard, all the ports are built in. On this one, actually, it's these interfaces back here that lead to all of the I/O. So this daughter board right here does 2 gigabit network ports. This one right here does 4, but these could easily be swapped out for other ports if the customer wanted a different configuration. And then this last one over here is what Dell calls their iDRAC. So this is our management port, a USB 3 port, and of course, VGA out so that you can hook it up to a display if you really want to. And then back here, look at these puppies. That's not your conventional PCI Express slot, but it definitely carries the same signal, so you can actually take, this guy right here, and that is what wires up to these PCI Express 16X slots that we're using for, our storage cards, network card, and, well, one of them's storage for our boot drive. Now, we fill it with Badgers. We're actually not quite filling it. We could put in one more Badger, but there was a limit to Liqid and Sabrent's generosity. The limit was 128 terabytes. I was like, okay. Okay, got a little bit of stress here, okay? Got a little bit of stress. If I break these, I do not have an easy way to replace them.
We could just call Dell, you know?
Yeah.
They might sell some warranties though.
How about the warranty? Like if something goes wrong, either with the hardware or software?
Well, that went so well, I think I'll do it again. Oh my God, I see what they mean by the cables being fragile. They're not even, there's no connector. What the hell is this?
Look at how small the wires are too.
What the heck?
Isn't that terrifying?
There it is. Theoretically, that's it. We're ready to roll this thing. Man, this thing's heavy. It's got a handle back here though, so you can just like carry it, right? No, please, don't worry. For something that doesn't have hard drives in it though, it's like, it's got some heft. I'm gonna need a hand. So, hey Jake, you ready to roll this thing?
Yeah, I guess.
Is this handle actually a handle?
Yeah, I think so.
I'm going for it.
Do you want me to let go and you just carry it? I kind of want to try.
I mean, I guess we should. It's our responsibility.
Oh, jeez, we're reviewing this chassis, right? All right, okay, go. Ooh, what was that?
Okay, you gotta take it.
You can't.
It's too heavy. What's up, L's and G's? Check this out. Look at them pretend to work when we walk in. Look at that. This is it. We're actually doing it this time. This is new Whonnock. It's not gonna have 20 terabytes. It's not gonna have 40 terabytes. It's gonna have 100 terabytes of storage.
Wow, so we don't have to delete anything ever?
No, that's not what I said. It's gonna have more storage though, and it'll be more reliable, Jake promises.
Jake promises.
I was expecting them to be more excited. Hey David, watch this. This is the world's fastest server.
Imagine if he tripped.
Now, this is not his permanent home. That's why there's no actual rails in here. We're actually gonna put it here in place of old Whonnock. We never actually deployed new Whonnock because we continued to have problems with it. So this is officially, I am christening it, new Whonnock.
Whonnock 3.
New Whonnock.
Whonnock, you know what, f*** it, new Whonnock.
New Whonnock. See you later, old Whonnock. And f*** you, new Whonnock.
Yeah, f*** you, new Whonnock.
That thing was. We already created our storage space and this is it, suckas. 104 flipping terabytes. See, it needs a minute here. It's gotta check how much capacity we got. What's my free space? I don't know, there's so much.
Did you tell them what kind of parity you were doing?
Right, we're running just single drive failure protection, single parity. And the reason for that, hold on. The reason for that is that this server will be doing by the minute backups to another local server, and then every probably hour or so, it'll be backing up offsite. So we're not really worried about like the drives failing, bricking the data.
Plus they're SSDs, so like failures are a lot less common.
Should be fine. Oh yeah, there it is.
100 gigabit?
Holy, wait, is it gonna show? Is it gonna show me a big number? Yeah. Now, a lot of people get confused when we show numbers like this. They're like, you can't even get internet that fast. Oh my God, I'm so tired of explaining it. That is not the point. It's a local network. We can get these speeds to local machines. Also, we have 10 gig internet, so like, we're gonna use a significant chunk of that, so, you know. Of course, to transfer at those kinds of speeds on the local network, you need some sick transceivers. So these are all of the server end transceivers that we're gonna be using. These are 25 gigabit from fs.com. Massive shout out to those guys. Great compatibility, great performance, and did I mention the price?
So good.
Freaking awesome. So we're gonna plug in these ends, then we're gonna go hook up all the editing machines and we're gonna do a live test.
Some problem, Edsel Iago, production manager for LinusMediaGroup.com?
Dennis can't seem to access Whonnock.
Interesting. Well, hey, good news. We're replacing it right now.
So is it gonna work as well as old Whonnock used to work too?
It should work better than it ever used to work.
Oh.
That's the plan.
Okay.
So give me like 10 minutes.
So it should never do anything like this.
I mean.
Okay, I don't know about
Jake
never.
Is staking his reputation on it,
yes,
but I don't
yes.
know if I
wait,
would.
Wait, I didn't, what? Why are you downloading Beyond Compare? Why don't you just use Cho Easy Copy?
I'm not using Cho Easy Copy.
Cho Easy Copy's so good though.
I love Beyond Compare and I trust it. So that's how this is gonna be. New plan, we're going back to our good friend Cho Easy Copy.
It's so good, man.
Oh, it sounds so stupid. But it's one of the only multi-threaded, just directory, take all this stuff and dump it over there programs. It's actually really robust.
3 gigabit.
And we're getting, I think we need 3 gigabytes a second.
2 to 3 gigabytes a second.
Yeah, so that's like 20 to 30 gigabit, which when you consider that we're plugged into a 40 gigabit network adapter on the old Whonnock side.
No, it's 100, I think.
Is it 100?
Yeah, but it's like.
Either way.
Yeah, it's still NTFS.
And it's like being used right now.
Yeah. We could try more threads.
I think it's okay.
I'm at 16.
Yeah, that looks pretty toasterific right there. I mean, we maxed out at 3.2 gigabytes a second. 2.4 gigs a second, dang! Ooh. Now that's hot. It's acid test time, and I actually like Mark's initial comment, so we're gonna interview him about the performance first.
Yeah, it's not bad.
Okay, so what happens in a multicam clip normally?
So usually what happens is I'll press play,
yeah,
and then I'll stop, and then it will keep going a couple of seconds, and then it'll stop.
Oh wait, so we actually have a tangible workflow improvement?
I guess you could say that if you want to justify it.
Wow, that actually wasn't my intention. We thought we were just adding like more storage. So this is
and
like,
improving latency.
Is this a noticeable difference?
Yeah, I'd say so.
Nice. No, this isn't something that we had tested. We knew the latency is better, but like it's not something that we were like, yes, we know that this will work better.
Yeah, and we didn't know that it was gonna have like a very real world, like tangible difference. We were just hoping. It's sort of, but we were sort of mostly hoping for improved stability and then also adding the capacity.
Something that we know from past experience is that when you have like a latency spike in terms of storage access on your remote server, it can cause not just one person's Premiere to crash, but like the entire editing den all at once will just go down. So the tighter we can keep those latencies, the better. And that means both networking and storage have to be as fast as possible.
So does it feel better?
Yeah, it's actually, like I'm playing at half res, but everything actually feels really snappy. And like Mark said, normally when you play a multicam sequence, it'll just run away from you, but yeah, this is actually stopping.
My jaw is like, my mouth is like,
I know.
You can't see it. I just like, I'm like, but you can't tell.
I know, I wasn't even hoping for like an actual performance improvement. I was just like, well, we'll just like show lots of people editing 8K at the same time and we'll be like, yeah, that's great, but hey, it's even better, yes.
You're not supposed to tell them that, damn it.
Well, what? Any thoughts, Dennis?
I'm playing in full, a new test.
Okay, but that's more of like a system bottleneck. Is this 8K or 12K, Brennan? That's 8K? Okay. Is that 8K red or Blackmagic? Blackmagic, okay.
It's pretty good. It is also, it's a multicam sequence.
Yeah, why is yours handling it and poor Mark's system chugged?
Mark's system always has sucked. I don't know why.
It's only one window. You don't have the actual multicam sequence.
Ah, okay.
Oh yeah, okay, you want to do that? Let's see. Yeah, quarter is actually pretty good. I have multicams here and program.
And remember, we've got everybody else hitting this same project at the same time.
This is on the new thing. I can like go around. Bam, bam, bam. This project is on the old one.
Oh, you've got it up and on both servers right now. What a pro.
Oh, yeah, you see? Look at that. There you go. Oh, wait, it's in full.
Wow, that, okay, hold on.
What? Okay.
That's huge.
Gotta have that Gen 4, baby, because remember, actually, Hoffman's only testing one aspect of the upgrade right now, because both of those servers are running at 100 gig right now. So that's actually just the Honey Badger, that's just that Honey Badger so power. Good. Honey Badger don't give a fuck.
He said fuck so many times this video. It's great.
All right, so good job, everyone. Good job, Jake. Good job, editors. Keep at it. Socially distanced fist bump or whatever. So all that's left is to thank everyone who helped with this project. Jake, the editing team for, you guys can actually go back to whatever you need to do now. Thank you very much, guys. Of course, Liqid for providing the server and their Honey Badgers, Micron for sending over their memory, FS.com for all the transceivers, Mellanox, excuse me, I mean NVIDIA for the high-speed networking gear. Man, those cards are so freaking sick. And am I missing anyone? And Sabrent, right, for sending over all the drives, 100 terabytes, and it's so fast. And infinite cables, thanks for the cables, guys. And right, our sponsor for the video. Storyblocks gets you studio quality stock video clips for a fraction of the cost. And you can download all the stock video your heart desires from their member library, including HD and 4K footage, After Effects templates, motion backgrounds, and more. We use it quite a bit on TechQuickie, and all the content is royalty free, so you can use it for personal projects like YouTube videos or commercial projects like, well, for us, YouTube videos are also commercial, but. New clips are added regularly, so there's always something fresh to download, so why wait? Check it out today at the link in the video description. If you guys enjoyed this video, you might enjoy the more in-depth look at both our high-speed networking as well as the high-speed storage with the Honey Badgers that we did with that server as a preview to this. Those were theoretical though. I'm really glad that it's actually working once we deployed it.
Woo! All I gotta say is f*** new Whonnock.
You mean new Whonnock? Oh no, yeah, no, new Whonnock. Yeah, new Whonnock, f*** that thing. New Whonnock, that's where it's at.
Whonnock 3.
New Whonnock.